Rhea, Saturn's hidden moon, full of surprises. Orbiting the gas giant Saturn from a distance of over 500,000 kilometers is a moon that's small but packed with mystery. This is Rhea, Saturn's second largest moon. Beneath its bright icy surface lies a world shaped by ancient impacts and mysterious tectonic activity. But recent discoveries have revealed startling details about this frozen satellite, from its faint oxygen atmosphere to its potential subsurface secrets. In this video, we will see if this frozen snowball could hold the chemical fingerprints of organic life, and what ancient forces keep Rhea's crater-filled surface dazzlingly reflective. The Saturnian system is full of surprises. This planet has rings made up of billions of ice particles, some as small as grains of sand, others as big as mountains. And let's not forget about Enceladus, which shoots geysers of water vapor into space. With Titan dominating headlines for its thick atmosphere and alien seas, Rhea has been left in the background. But this heavily cratered moon is no less extraordinary, as it seems to hold the potential for a subsurface ocean. This leaves us with a bigger question. What if the most overlooked moon in our solar system held answers to some of our biggest cosmic questions? To unpack that, let's start with some important context. Rhea is one of Saturn's major moons and the second largest after Titan. It was discovered on December 23, 1672 by Giovanni Domenico Cassini, an Italian-born French astronomer. The moon was named after Rhea, a Titan from Greek mythology. Rhea is about 1,528 kilometers in diameter, roughly half the size of our moon. To imagine its size, think of stretching Rhea across the United States. It would cover the distance from Chicago to Denver. The moon orbits Saturn at a distance of 527,000 kilometers and takes 4.5 Earth days to complete one orbit. Like many other large moons, Rhea is tidally locked, meaning the same side always faces Saturn. Rhea's surface is incredibly reflective, bouncing back about 70% of the sunlight that hits it. This high reflectivity comes from the fact that its surface is mostly made of water ice. But don't imagine a smooth, featureless sheet of ice. Rhea's surface is covered in craters that tell the story of its ancient, violent history. Take Mammoldi, Rhea's largest crater, as an example. It spans a massive 480 kilometers, roughly the distance between Paris and Amsterdam. Some craters on Rhea have darker patches at their bottoms, which is a clue that impacts might have exposed darker material from beneath the bright surface. This darker material could be made of amorphous water ice or impact melted debris. And then there are Rhea's thin streaks. These bright, overlapping lines were first seen in detail by the Voyager spacecraft in the 1980s. But their true nature wasn't clear until NASA's Cassini mission decades later. At first, scientists thought the streaks were just frost or ice deposits. It turns out that they're actually enormous ice cliffs, some hundreds of meters high. These cliffs likely formed when the moon's icy crust cracked and shifted, with parts of the surface being thrust upward. These features give us a glimpse into Rhea's tectonic activity and the forces that shaped it over billions of years. But Rhea's secrets don't stop at its surface. In 2010, scientists made a surprising discovery. Rhea has a thin atmosphere, or exosphere. Fun fact, the oxygen found was about 5 trillion times less dense than Earth's atmosphere at sea level. In other words, it was incredibly faint. This atmosphere is mostly made up of oxygen and carbon dioxide. Where does this oxygen come from? The theory is that charged particles from Saturn's powerful magnetic field bombarded Rhea's surface, breaking apart water, ice, and releasing oxygen. Carbon dioxide might be the result of organic molecules on Rhea reacting with oxygen in its exosphere. While this atmosphere isn't anything like what we need to breathe, it's still a big deal. Rhea is one of the few moons in the solar system known to have an oxygen atmosphere, joining Jupiter's moons Europa and Ganymede. This discovery also raises interesting questions about how Saturn's magnetosphere interacts with its moons. Rhea's thin atmosphere and the clues from its surface features give scientists valuable insights into how moons evolve over time and how they're influenced by their parent planets. So this moon's heavily cratered surface gives it an aged, weathered appearance. But its mysteries extend far deeper than its exterior. Now, what secrets does Rhea hold beneath its icy surface? And how does Rhea's interior compare to other moons in the Saturn system? Let's start with what we know. Rhea has an average density of 1.236 grams per cubic centimeter. To put that in perspective, it's only slightly denser than water, which means this moon is mostly made of water ice mixed with about 25% rocky material. Imagine a cosmic snowball with a dash of dirt. That's what Rhea looks like. This odd composition gives it a unique place among Saturn's moons, many of which show a similar ice-rock blend but with distinct differences in proportions. The Cassini spacecraft, one of humanity's most ambitious missions, gave us a closer look at Rhea's surface. Using spectroscopic observations, scientists confirmed water ice dominates the moon's crust. But that's not all. Cassini also detected carbon dioxide trapped in the surface ice. This discovery hints at the presence of complex organic molecules, the building blocks of life. While Rhea's frigid surface is far from habitable, these findings raise questions about its chemical evolution and whether more intriguing materials might be hidden deeper below. What lies beneath Rhea's icy crust is an even bigger puzzle. Based on its moment of inertia, a measure of how mass is distributed within an object, scientists believe Rhea is homogeneous, with no distinct layers like other moons such as Europa or Ganymede. This implies it never got warm enough for its materials to separate into layers of rock and ice. But here is where things get interesting. Not every expert agrees. A 2006 study suggested that Rhea might, against all odds, harbor a subsurface ocean. While speculative, this idea draws parallels to moons like Europa and Enceladus, where hidden oceans are known to exist. If Rhea truly has liquid water beneath its surface, it would transform how we see this frozen moon, offering the tantalizing possibility of habitability, however slim. After all, where there's water, there's the potential, however remote, for life. Adding to the intrigue is Rhea's peculiar shape. It's not a perfect sphere, but rather a triaxial ellipsoid, meaning it's slightly squashed at the poles and bulging at the equator. This unusual shape suggests a non-uniform internal structure, possibly caused by a concentration of denser material away from its center. This unexpected quirk challenges traditional models of moon formation and adds yet another layer to Rhea's growing list of mysteries. Now, let's travel back to one of the most fascinating moments in our understanding of Rhea, the Cassini mission's close flybys. This remarkable spacecraft, a joint project by NASA, the European Space Agency, the ESA, and the Italian Space Agency, spent over a decade exploring Saturn and its moons. Among its many achievements, Cassini provided unprecedented insights into Rhea, Saturn's second largest moon, unraveling mysteries that had puzzled astronomers for decades. Cassini's journey was a triumph of engineering and collaboration. Launched in 1997, it reached the Saturnian system in 2004 and remained operational until 2017. Its mission wasn't just about taking pictures. It was a deep dive into the complexities of Saturn, its rings, and its moons. Rhea, often overshadowed by its more famous siblings like Titan and Enceladus, came into the spotlight during several close flybys that revealed its unique characteristics. The closest encounter occurred on January 11, 2011, when Cassini flew just 76 kilometers above Rhea's surface. This was followed by another close approach on March 9, 2013, at a distance of 997 kilometers. These flybys allowed Cassini to capture detailed images of Rhea's surface, revealing two distinct terrains, heavily cratered regions and smoother plains. The heavily cratered areas date back to the early solar system, offering a record of intense bombardments billions of years ago. Meanwhile, the younger, smoother regions suggest resurfacing events, possibly from impact ejecta that covered older craters. Cassini also provided critical data about Rhea's composition. The spacecraft's instruments confirm that Rhea's surface is dominated by water ice, with a sprinkling of rocky material. However, one of its more intriguing findings was what it didn't find: a detectable internal magnetic field. This absence suggests that Rhea lacks a molten core or other sources of significant internal activity, making it a geologically quiet moon. But the surprises didn't end there. In 2005, measurements hinted that Rhea might host a ring system, a discovery that would have been unprecedented for a moon. However, during its close flybys, Cassini found no evidence of rings. This non-detection cast doubt on the initial theory, suggesting that any potential debris around Rhea might be too diffuse or temporary to observe. The mystery of Rhea's possible rings remains unresolved, adding yet another layer of intrigue to this icy world. Rhea's position within Saturn's E-ring, formed by cryovolcanic eruptions from Enceladus, also caught scientists' attention. As Rhea orbits through the region, it interacts with ice particles from the E-ring, which may influence its surface properties. These interactions could explain Rhea's bright appearance, as its surface gets continually refreshed by incoming particles. Cassini's mission to Rhea was a demonstration of the power of exploration. Through detailed imaging, composition analysis, and close observations, it transformed our understanding of this icy moon. From its ancient cratered landscapes to its possible connections with Saturn's dynamic ring system, Rhea stands as a reminder that even the quietest corners of the solar system can hold astonishing secrets. What does the future hold for the exploration of Rhea? While Cassini's mission provided incredible insights, it was just the beginning of what we can learn about this icy moon. Rhea remains a prime target for future missions, especially as scientists continue to explore the outer reaches of our solar system. Also, the intrigue surrounding Rhea is deepened by theories of cryovolcanism, the existence of prebiotic chemistry, and the potential for an ocean hidden beneath its icy crust. Scientists are continuing to study Saturn's moons, and future missions may provide the answers to some of the most pressing questions about Rhea. While there aren't any specific missions planned for Rhea this year, any spacecraft sent to study Saturn and its moons will probably take a look at it. In the meantime, Rhea remains a moon of speculation and wonder. Its mysterious surface and faint exosphere provide ample ground for theories, and as our technology improves, we may one day find that Rhea has far more to offer than we've ever imagined. Whether or not if it ever harbors life is still up in the air, but its role in our understanding of icy moons and the potential for life beyond Earth is undeniable. Rhea, like so many other bodies in our solar system, continues to challenge our imagination and push the boundaries of what we know about the universe. And that's a wrap. What do you find spectacular about this moon? Feel free to leave your answers in the comments below. If you liked the video, then check out the one on your screen. This video on the mysterious planet hiding between Mars and Jupiter will blow your mind. Thanks for watching.